Hey, it's Joe Glyons from the Automator, and today we're going to talk about the Windows Management Instrumentation. That's a mouthful, so I'm going to say WMI. So much easier. Anyway, it's a really, really powerful code that you can access via a COM object, the COM object get. And let me read it right from here. It says, the Windows Management Information System is the plumbing through which nearly all Windows resources can be accessed, configured, managed, and monitored. Right? Like, that sounds pretty impressive. Let me show you the page that I had created for us to with some great resources for this, and then we'll go into some of the example scripts. Here you can download, there's 34 different scripts I have all together, zipped together for you. I'll show a couple, but because they peek inside your computer and reveal a lot of really juicy information, I'm not going to run them all here because I don't want to give you that stuff out. This WMI scripting primer, there's three different parts, really great information broken out. They explain a lot of the stuff on the CIM common information model and stuff and what you're doing and how to access the stuff. I highly recommend you check those out if you're interested in actually getting the guts. Now, of course, just like most things, you don't actually have to go read all this stuff. You can just use the scripts, right? But if you want to understand, because of what's presented here, it's just a fraction of what's available, right? So just let me know what's out there. I found these three different posts in the forum. There's a lot of overlap in the content of them, but these are actually people on the forum who have posted AutoHotkey scripts, a lot of which I borrowed and put in the links here, or in this download. And then here were some other resources that I had found. Again, just lots of really amazing stuff about the WMI and how you can be used. So let's go ahead and get into some of the code. So here, like I said, here are all the different scripts. So let's say if I wanted to see what anti-spyware, the status of my anti-spyware. So I'm going to drop it into here just so we can take a peek at a couple of them, right? What basically you use the COM object get to ping, and you're going to look for a certain thing, right? Like here's this anti-spyware product. And that is going to have a lot of, values that it can pull out. Now, the thing is, you have to know what these are. And that's where it's like, wow, it's a lot of information. And I don't even know if the person that put this script together got all the information that's inside this, piece of value. So you're going to have to do some homework here. But let's go ahead and run it. And this just displays a message box showing you, Windows Defender, I think actually... Is this the anti-spyware? No, spyware, I think, was just Windows Defender. It shows you what's going on. The antivirus one, if I remember correctly, and let's just go ahead and run that one. That shows Windows Defender and, because I have Malwarebytes running also, so it shows both of those. It's iterating over them. The architecture, that wasn't too interesting. Let's do a CPU. I'm going to run that. And here now I have... Some of these will dump into a text file, and that's why I have site up here. So here you can see the different information. I have a Threadripper, Ryzen Threadripper from AMD, but it shows you the information about it. And like I said, you can get the RAM, you can get a ton. So let's just take a look here. There's a ton of information that it peeks in there. When you like the drives, goes over your hard drives. And this is a real short one. I have two. There's that one and this one. This one goes a much deeper level of the hard drives. And what's available in there. Installed audio codecs. Like, I don't know why you'd want to know that. List of installed programs, right? Installed fonts. Both of those take a while to run because it's a lot of information, but it goes and rips them out for you. The user account, system accounts, memory, your motherboard. Like, it's crazy the amount of information that's in here. Let's go ahead and look at, let me run mouse. At least there's nothing secret. Here it pulls back this information. Let's look at the script. I'll just say edit. And here we can see, how it's, again, it's iterating over the thing. This root simv2, whatever the world it is, and pulling out information. Now here we're enumerating over each item and getting them and dumps it. Oh, this is the while object. So yeah, it's getting them and it dumps it into here. And someone just says, hey, when it says resolution, put the word resolution with a new line. And that's what it's pulling up. So to me, it was a fascinating thing. I think I used this when I was first looking to say, how would I lock down a program if I was going to sell it, like pull information about the motherboard and about the RAM. And this is the tool I had used, but I don't think I ever had a specific video talking through this stuff. So I've created a site here. You can see the URL. Just go to the-automator.com/WMI. It'll bring up this main page, this page. And from there you can get the download or you can get all the resources. Like I said, it's We could do a couple webinars, I think, on this topic alone. It's a lot of information there, but it's another great thing. AutoHotkey, this makes it so easy, right? So, cheers.